Hey, happy Tuesday evening. Assuming I get this done in time, it's Tuesday evening. Yeah, y'all see my grapevine back there. It's always got itty bitty grapes on it. Let me get Thursday morning, Friday morning, we're getting weather in the mid-30s, so getting a little hairy around here. Anyway, this footage was shot from April 14th to 18th or so. So it's a mid-April tour of where the garden's at during last week. Check it out. There's some pretty photos in here. Got some nice, pretty azaleas in it. As you can see, we've added two elderberries to the mix back here. I'll have more to say about elderberries later. This is just it's in the ground. We'll talk about this clay and whatnot. Something else I discovered that's got me a little concerned. But anyway, I tucked them inside. I believe you're supposed to let them grow wild for the first 2 years, and then in the third year you prune them to the size you want. So the idea is to get them to box in right here inside of the blackberry there, which is also going to spread its canopy, and this grapevine. A sentimental grapevine I planted a long time ago. Doesn't produce much, but that's my little buddy. And then this one's got a tighter spot. But assuming it grows back here, it gets up as high as this fence, and then that will be the prune for height. Ends with another blackberry. That's the weaker of the two, but I think it'll be okay in the long term. So peaceful. That's some lemon balm. I love how the shadows clip through here in the morning. There's birds chirping. I don't know if you heard that train blowing its whistle. You can hear the city coming to life with the cars buzzing around and the horns. But yeah, those are some early Alaska peas on the backside. And the beans have come in. It didn't take long. Hit 10 out of 12. And these beans were given to me. One was from up against those okra sticks. There were white half runners that I got from MB Heritage Farms. And then by the black post there, there's only one on this side, there's two on the other. And those are Chinese, I think they're called snake beans. One of those didn't hit. And then one of eight on the other, so one in four and one in eight. But you know, I'll take 10 for 12 out of saved beans. And I didn't plant two per spot, I just went one for what I wanted. And I'll just go back and plant what didn't come up. Got a little bit of clover and whatnot in here, which I don't mind clover, but there's some other weeds in there. But not all of that is weeds. There's some basil, okra, excuse me, garlic. And all those little white tags you see, that's where I plant it by seed. Zinnia, feather celosia, which I saved myself from last year, and something called bright wings. All supposed to be good companions for tomatoes. There's a little bit of parsley in there. And down at the end, you see a couple of summer squash. Those are round zucchini. I'm going to finish getting the grass out of that. And then back over here, that's on the list this week too. Clean all that out and start my Carolina hybrid cucumbers. I'll show you a couple of surprises. This is the old mulch pile back here. Some of that stuff in there, the green in the middle of the leaves, actually potatoes. They came up. I thought they weren't coming, so I was going to do something else there. And then they came up. So back there are some blueberries. You see that tall bushy thing? That's lemon balm. I dug that out of the ground last year. There's a little pit back there. I didn't really dig a hole. I just tossed the root ball in the pit to see if it would take. And it did. I'm not kidding you, man. That stuff is over 2 foot tall. Again, I did not do anything but dig out the root ball, set it over there, cut it back. Those roots took to what was beneath it. And it's prolific. So don't have to worry about lemon balm for a while. No, sir. And that's a loofah in a pot. Still green, but not hit a growth spurt. I'm gonna have to jack that up with some nitrogen. Get a little steroid boost. And that's a little pile of crap I gotta clean out. That ain't even half of the stuff I took out of this corner back here. I'm not kidding you. I've already moved much more than that. It's a viney jungle. And then something I've been showing the last few days on Instagram quite a bit. I just call it a pink azalea. I didn't plant it, so I don't know exactly what it is. And I'm not a botanist. Let's see if I can get a close-up on these flowers for you. Yeah, I love coming out here in the sunrise, just the way that light clips through there. It's beautiful. All right, let's move on to the next thing. Okay, so these are Rose of Sharon. I once had two. I think my purple one's gone, I'm pretty sure. We'll find out. This is all covered up in hedge up until last year. But now, you know, you can see there's three of them. I only started with two. And then if you look at the base of the plum tree, there's number four, which is going to have to be dug out at the end of this year. I'll make a ball out of the bottom of it. Probably wait, let it sit over winter and then move it in the spring next year. And these I'll probably dig up after the blooms are gone. There's I think 13 in there. One of them I'll leave to finish this little spot here, and I'll take the others and put them in containers. Save some and maybe sell some. But yeah, I had been letting the blooms just dry up for years. Just let them dry up and they drop. You can see one I missed on the tip there. Let me go back and grab him. But I did just did hit all this stuff, but obviously a lot of them's already dropped too. So that's what you get to get your little babies natural propagation, I guess. And back to that freeze we had. We had back-to-back freezes. So I wasn't sure, and I could see quite a few, but you won't be able to see all that on the camera, but you can see that. So, when I say freeze, we're talking 27 and 28 back-to-back nights. It's in the vlog. And this tree is covered up with them, so. We made it. Well, we made it through the freeze. But don't count your plums until they're ripe. But so far, so good. There's another shot of that lemon balm. I need to get in there and pull out some of the crap that's not supposed to be in there, but that's pretty pure, actually. Loving that lemon balm. Wednesday evening, I done got tuckered out again, although I'm not done yet. I still got to get those in containers. Found me two. I'm sure I'll find two more. Oh, I'll tell you what that is. Strut my stuff. On the right, jalapeno. On the left, Cubanelle, I love that pepper. Love that pepper. Substitute it for a banana pepper or substitute it for a bell pepper and stuff it. Mm-hmm. All right, so before I explain what I did today or this afternoon, evening, please know if you're watching me for the first time, this is Jules Small Gardening and I experiment. I do things they tell you not to do. So I'm just showing you what I do. I'm not telling you to do this. All right. So there are two starts. There's a round zucchini. One seed and a start transplanted a couple weeks ago. There are four more hills. They have two seeds per hill. And I will initially thin it to one a hill. But these hills, by recommendation, are too close. That's okay. I'm gonna let it play out first to see if I need to thin it. If I do, I do, and if I don't, I don't. Now the peppers, I gave them plenty of space because I need those peppers. All right, in the middle here, these are speckled Roman pasting tomatoes. In the middle of this is compact basil from Livingston. Seeds, which is a subsidiary of Ferry Morse. I highly recommend that. That is a nice, nice basil. All right, so other thing I worked on this evening. Yeah, organic thyme. We have it going on now. This is our cucumber trellis. Oh yeah. Now, let's see if I get a little closer. You see a crescent arc. That's not a ditch. Those are individual hills, okay. As they go. In the middle is Carolina Hybrid. And on the front post, like right there, that's a lemon cucumber. Okay. And then there's Daikon Radish that follows that crescent under that mulch, which is grass from my yard. Top of the mulch piles that's been sitting there a little short of a week. But yeah. Keeping stuff down, it smells so good, you know that, right? And this hill hanging out by itself is actually a bush cucumber. Now give it its space. And then that's my cherry tomato. Had to have it, didn't see any volunteers, so I had to go buy me one. And it's gonna run up that post right there. Yeah. Anyway, same thing. These are 3-2s. 3 seeds, thin it to 2, see what happens. The hills are much closer than recommended. I've done it before and it's been okay. And I'm not telling you to do this, I'm just showing you what I do. And you know, you can always thin stuff later. If you don't plant it, it ain't got a chance, right? So, all right, so now you see, this right here is not mulched yet. Neither are the beans, that lemon thyme back there. Or the main paste and tomato bed, which has some herbs in it and some flowers and whatnot. I'll be going back through here, mulching with the grass when I get the next cut and let it set for a while. And although I have some grass left over, I might start doing that tomorrow or this weekend. But I'll be adding some candy onions in here as well. But not over there with the beans, over here with the tomatoes. And probably on the front row to keep them far away from those beans. Anyhow, that's what I did today, and I need to go take a nap. Y'all be blessed. Hey, Coco. Look here, man. Childers Classic Barbecue Peanuts. Did you hear that? There we go. Pretty good, isn't it? The flavor's not overbearing. You can still taste the peanut. Virginia peanut, too. Look at you. You caught 2 in a row.
All right, he's spoiled.
That dog, this dog is blind. He barks at me if I'm too far away. Dang, he caught 3 in a row.
That's close, man.
All right, come get this one you missed. Let's not get overboard. Here, here's the one you missed. It's right there. Crunching it like a pro.
Man, it smell like fish.
Good morning, Saturday, early Saturday. My head's all stuffed up as usual from the allergies and the pollen. But yeah, I did a little work over here yesterday afternoon. Got the latest experiment in play. That's a 10-gallon grow bag. And I decided to put Moon and Stars watermelon in there. Put something on that edge, I think, to keep that vine nice and comfortable. So I'm not going to trellis this. I'm going to bring it out and hopefully train it across that lip of that bag. I'll probably put some insulation like you'd put on a pipe, a water pipe. Put that on the lip of that bag so we don't damage the vine, and then try to train it to run. We're looking south, so try to train it to run up this gap here. Hopefully. Of course, it's going to get all over this blueberry. That was a bare root blueberry I put in last year. Yes, that's right. We thought we had dried out our potato eyes too much, and I guess we didn't, because here they come. That's a really old mulch / brush pile. That's some good soil in there. So pretty. Yeah, back in that corner with that watermelon will be, I think I'm gonna go ahead and try that snake gourd. since I got it. Hands in the Dirt said, if you have the seed, plant the seed. And right through here, I have flip-flops on. I'm an idiot. But you can see right here is where you get, your eyes ain't gonna pick up on Mr. Small Snakey Snakey. But generally speaking, you can walk right across a copperhead. They won't bother you if you don't bother them, basically. But if you step on them, then you got a problem. Oh, my head's so stopped up this morning. Elderberry. You can see, this is a blackberry, one of two. And you can see all the blooms coming in. Looking good, looking good. And so back here, in front of this grapevine, I'm gonna put another grow bag and run a crimson sweet watermelon. And even if it doesn't produce fruit, that's fine. If we could get that vine all over this area, the base of this is moss. And so, hopefully they kill off a lot of this stuff. So I don't want to spray anything over here because of this dogwood and these azaleas. I need to prune that one pretty good this year. And this one, I need to get in there and finish getting the vine off the base. But they did get their spring feeding. I used holly mix. Welcome to that jungle. All right, eyeballs to the ground just to make sure I don't step on a snake. We've already seen two this year. Saw one and Beth found one. Came across three copperheads last year, which I wasn't happy about, but what you gonna do? Peas are doing okay. Beans came up. It's old Pete's. Pete, I'm sorry, last night we got to going on Eva's live. I lost track of time and we finished, it was 11 o'clock, man. Those are the Chinese snake bean. I think that's what that is. It's a Chinese noodle bean. Yeah, snake born noodle bean. Sorry. As you can tell, I'm not cheating looking at paper. Right now, I'm just trying to breathe. White half runners coming up even better since the last video or the last filming. Tomatoes that we started inside are all greening up nice. Just coming along. Hey, look off in the distance there. Look at that. I mean, some healthy radish right there. They love that dirt, that's for darn sure. All right, I gotta get some water down before the sun gets up. It's my battle axe. I might take him into action today. By the way, that's right, that's another potato. Start them in the grow bag and they weren't doing anything. And like I said, I thought we had let them dry out too much. But that one said, you're not killing me. So here it comes. Potato in the mulch pile. It's all gravy. Well, good Sunday morning to you. All right, let's get right to it. So this is our Green's grocery store, and I've gone ahead and put in the second seating. The 2 foot of that is more of the mixed greens, which is all the way down on the other end. And then there's about a square foot of romaine and a square foot of butter crunch. That's some arugula that I may or may not thin out. That's some Lee Rin Choy right there. No, that's not. That's spinach right there. That's the Lee Rin Choy, and that's been thinned out a bit. Nice little compact choy. And I gotta get in here and thin some of this butter crunch out. My gosh, that seed just loved that spot, didn't it? And then down here, that's the romaine, and it's thinner. It's right after I planted this, and a big old rain that came in and washed through. I'm surprised it hit that rectangle and not that one. And that's our mixed greens. You have green mustard, red mustard, Chinese cabbage, pak choy, and tat zoi. And we're gonna start eating on that and thinning it. I do it selectively and leave several of the plants alone. So we'll thin and eat as we go, and then hope the other stuff forms up, particularly the Chinese cabbage. And on the other side, oh, by the way, I snuck a habanero in here in a pot. That's not a habanero, that's a jalapeno. It's first thing in the morning, y'all, give me a break. That's a bird's eye in the wall, bird's eye pepper. And that's a habanero in there. Anyways, I'm standing above the cabbage patch, interrupted by my Italian parsley, which, by the way, starting to go to seed. Yes, 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 thank you. We'll grab some of that when the time comes. In the meantime, whoops, sorry, got out of focus there. Still doesn't want to focus, does it? In the meantime, we will continue to eat on that. And then back here, it transitions into some broccoli starts, although there are 3 red cabbage tucked away in there. And obviously, I need to get my mulch on. But it's coming along. The trench, I still need to finish weeding it, but that's not a hurry. That's going to be the okra. It's nowhere near hot enough for that stuff to do its thing anyway. Just a nice chill Sunday morning. Oh, look at here. I decided not to move that pile. Now that pile I will move, but this pile is going to stay. I'm going to box it up with this old red bud I had to cut down. Top it off with some more mulch. And I'm going to put a pumpkin in there. That's right, I'm going to grow a pumpkin in there. hopefully train it to run down this bed. And on the other end, peeking out there, that's a spaghetti squash that I don't trust. It's not dead, but it's not really doing anything, so could be the weather, but I don't trust it because of where I got it from. And so I'll be adding to that. And then there's the corn coming in, but unfortunately only 6 of 11 hit. Don't know why, but I'm gonna have to add to it because it's not gonna be enough to have a shot at any kind of pollination. In this bed, see, I was telling you this earlier during the vlog series. I said, dang wiregrass, man, that stuff is tough to get out. Been fighting that for years. It's the only place left in the yard that exists. It's right here. But there's a weed mat under there, and this stuff gets in there and under there, and it's just hard to get it all out. So I need to dig this whole thing up, basically. But in the meantime, I'm going to use this space to try to run some winter squash. Either it do or it don't. There's our little bird center. Yeah, there's the south garden. Oh, check it out. I think I showed this already, but nice sunshine look on it. I'll grab me some collard seeds. Yep. So what's on the agenda for today? I will be heading out to a Carolinas, Club Carolinas member to hand off this box. And there's three people that want that box. Two I know are Carolinas. I can't remember if the third one's in Carolina or not. But it's gonna be getting down the road today. We're deploying our Club Carolinas UPS system again. We'll be hitting the road here in about an hour.
We are finishing the delivery. It's Club Carolinas UPS system. My name is CMB. Heritage Farms.
Can't get away from Lowe's.
Cannot get away from Lowe's. But we're not headed to Statesville.
Thank God.
We are, but we're not stopping there.
Beautiful lawn. Jules grows grass. Yes, I do. And there you go. Didn't quite get enough to finish my tomatoes. I still have some under this dogwood tree. I'll probably grab it. Hopefully today. And that should be enough to finish the tomatoes and get started over here with the beans. Just to hold the moisture down, keep the weeds down a little bit. Everybody's looking nice and healthy and wet over here. My understanding is peas like a lot of water. Correct me if I'm wrong, please. I don't want to drown my peas. But, yep. Nice green and sunny day. So let me go spend a few hours in the car. It's all cool. I like taking rides in the country.
All right, thanks for hanging out and chatting. Or if you're watching the replay, leave comments down there. Let me know what you think. Give me recommendations or whatever. I hope everybody makes it through in my area here the next few nights. Looks like my camera stand's about to blow over. Guess I better wrap this up. 3, 2, 1. Peace, y'all.